Can you get three golf bags in the trunk? Is it big enough to put golf bags in?
The only eventful part, I think, is pointing out one stork's nest. it's autobahn and sort of countryside. It's a bit of a salad basket in this area, so there's lots of fruit and veg and stuff being grown once we get outside of Kehl. So we are staying, obviously, in Germany. We're not crossing over into France. And as I said, we'll be there in about 50 minutes. Please do fasten your seatbelts. That is, there's about a little under 7,000 miles of Autobahn in Germany. The first Autobahn was built in the 30s, and then from then they just expanded and grew. The big thing sticking in the right lane, excuse me, if you're driving less than or 100 kilometers or less. To get a driving license in Germany, well, it's not quite as easy as in some countries, and it is fairly expensive. You can expect to pay anything from about 3,000 to 5,000 euros, depending upon how good you are in the beginning, because you are obliged to take driving lessons with a driving instructor from a driving school. So you can't just learn with a family member and then get behind the wheel and take your test. You have to take official lessons, 20 of them. You have to take an exam. When you take your driving test, you're with your instructor plus the test, the person who's sort of monitoring your test drive. And so, yeah, it can be expensive, especially if you don't pass the first time. They did some studies about the autobahns, and they said, they were talking about, there's always this ongoing talk about should they impose speed limits. All of the big car manufacturers like Porsche and Mercedes and Audi, they of course don't want any speed limits because they know that people like fast cars, and if you've got a fast car, you want to be able to drive it somewhere. But they did some studies, and they found that 67% of all accidents on autobahns are not surprisingly, caused by excess of speed. With your insurance companies, if you're found to have caused an accident or had an accident at a high speed, chances are you won't get your payment or very little off. So that all factors in. We did a couple of weeks ago when we were driving to Mercedes, we actually had four cars that went past us. We had a Ferrari, a Porsche, a McLaren, and there was one other. Ferrari, an Audi, I think it was. It was an Audi, a Ferrari, a McLaren, and a Porsche, all in bright colours. And they were doing actually something like speeding on a circuit. They were driving down about 50 kilometres, and they passed us twice in the time it took us to get to Rastatt. So keep your eyes peeled. You might see some interesting driving on the way. Okay, I'll be quiet for a while. silent. Yeah. It's like Sharon. Sharon says she never relaxes. She always. We are doing fine.
Thank you. cute. This is lovely.
Bet the bus. ladies and gentlemen, we are just driving through the town of Rastatt, and just on the outskirts we'll find the Mercedes-Benz factory. Good news, the tour is inside today. Okay, so just to give you a bit of an outline of our program. So when we arrive at the Mercedes plant, we'll leave the coach and make our way into the visitor center. There are some restrooms there that we can use. We can have a look around some of the exhibitions that are there in the visitor center, and also to have a look, quick look at the... So you can see the plant over here on our left.